State can now grant temporary virtual learning waivers to schools who submit a request.
Right. This morning, News Channel 5's Cole Johnson is going in-depth for us on just how many of those requests are getting approved right now. Cole, good morning. What have you learned?
Hey, good morning, guys. For starters, for some perspective, we know that these waivers are specifically for classrooms and schools, not entire districts. And in a letter, Commissioner Penny Schwinn says that she expects these waivers to be narrowly applied. But let's get into these numbers because that really is the big story here. Now, the department says they've gotten 14 formal waiver requests since Monday. They mentioned three of them do not require waivers, saying in two cases, all individual students could be quarantined, making the waiver not necessary. And the third is because instruction wasn't provided. But let's look at the eligible requests according to the department. In total, there are 11. 8 are approved for the temporary transition to remote learning. 1 is partially approved and 2 were denied. The department explains why the 2 were denied. In one case, there weren't any staff shortages. Half the students could still go to school. In the other, 92% of students were still in person. And the department says there were, quote, sufficient teachers for in-person instruction and learning. And this all comes as Tennessee sets another record, as we've mentioned, with COVID hospitalizations all ahead of a holiday weekend. And the CDC actually has a special ask for unvaccinated Americans. Amelia, they say the risks are just too high.